Hello and welcome to our channel LibreCat Tutorial. Today we are playing on LibreCat again, our lovely software for two-dimension CAD. Okay, next, today I want to draw an object. The object is on the screen now, the object image on the screen, and then I think we should start now. Please activate some snap function on your desktop. Please activate free snap, snap on endpoint, snap center and snap middle, snap intersection. And next, I think we should use a rectangle to help us to draw this image. Okay, select rectangle tool, rectangle. Left click to put the rectangle on the screen now. Okay, go to command line form and draw a rectangle. The diameter, the dimension for rectangle is 60 on the horizontal and 60 also on the vertical. Okay, type add 60, 60 and press enter. Right click to escape. Now we should draw line diagonally for this rectangle. Select line tool, 2 points, draw diagonal line here. Okay, right click to escape, draw again the another side. Okay, right click. Okay, right click again. Okay, now we should delete the rectangle, we don't need it anymore. Select the rectangle and press delete on the keyboard. Now time to create 4 circles, 4 small circles here. Okay, select circles tool, circle center point. The circle diameter or the circle radius will be 6. R6. Okay, the radius will be 6, so put the circle into the end of this diagonal line and then go to command line form, type radius for the circle 6 and press enter. Repeat the procedure. Okay, for the bottom side 6 and press enter. On the left side, okay, radius 6 and press enter. On the top of left side, left click, go to command line form, type radius 6 and press enter. Okay, now time to draw the big circle here at the middle of our drawing. Left click at the middle of our object and go to command line form, type radius 15 and press enter. Okay, next, right click to escape. I think I will delete this part, this line. It will be used relative angle tool. Select relative angle, type angle 90, length type length 20, okay, middle points 1, okay, and then left click at the line here and put the line like this. Okay, right click to escape and then left click again at the line here and put the line into the position. Oops, sorry, I have made a mistake for this part. Okay, right click now, right click again and delete this line, sorry. Okay, select relative angle and left click at the line here and put the line into the position. The right position is in the middle of this, in the center of this circle. Right click, now left click at the line here and left click to put the line into the position, right click, left click at the line here, and left click again to put the line into the position, right click to escape, and next right click again. Okay, next I want to draw this part. There are four shape like this, four shapes like this. The diameter for this shape is 15. Okay, I think we should use circle center point again. Left click at the center of this circle. Go to common line form, type radius 15 and press enter. Repeat the procedure on the other side. Okay. Next again. Okay, next right click to escape. No time to draw. I think we should draw line between this circle into this circle. Okay, select the line tools, 2 points maybe. You can use another tool on the line tools, but I prefer choose 2 points line. Okay, draw line like this. Right click to escape, draw line like this. Okay, right click to escape, draw again the line. Right click to escape, draw the line, and right click to escape. And now right click to escape from the line tool. Okay, next I want to draw this part, this arch. I will use I think we should use fillet tool. Select fillet tool, fillet. Okay, fillet tool. The radius for the arch is 15. Type radius 15 at the column box here. I think we should unmark the trim and needle points on OK. Left click at this line, left click at another line. Repeat the same procedure. Okay, right click to escape now. No time to remove unnecessary lines and finish our job. Okay, select I think we should use defy tool. Select defy tool. Okay, start from this line, left click at the point, left click again at the line, left click at this point. Okay, next line, left click at the line, left click again at the point, left click at the line until the line change the color. Okay, now left click at the line, at left click at the point, left click again at the line, left click at the point you want to remove. Okay, left click at the line, right click to escape, and select the unnecessary lines. Okay, and press delete on the keyboard. Okay, oh, I think we should delete this part of the circle. Okay, I will use trim tool. Select trim and left click at the limiting line, left click at the circle we want to trim. Okay, you can click more than once if trim tool not function properly. Okay, left click, right click to escape, and left click to select limiting line. Left click again at the circle we want to trim. Right click to escape. Left click at the line as a limiting line. Left click at the circle. Right click, and now right left click at the circle, select at press escape no left select again trim tool, left click at the line, and left click at the circle you want to trim. Okay, now right click to escape. Oh, I think we have to change the type of this line. So select all of this line, and then select attributes, select line type, change the line type into DOS small. Okay. No time to give a dimension for our drawing, but before we give dimension for our drawing, I think we should create a single layer special for dimension. Okay, left click at the plus button here at the layer list column, left click, and type the name for our layer. As a sample type dimension for layer name. Select color, maybe dark magenta. Select width, okay, 0.3, it's okay, and click OK. Activate dimension layer here. Now time to give dimension. We start from horizontal. Select horizontal dimension, and then left click at the point. Okay. Now time to give dimension for vertical. Right click to escape. Select dimension vertical. Okay, right click to escape. Okay, I think I should change the dimension setting. There are many zero numbers here behind the comma. So select current range preferences, and then open tab dimension. Change the linear precision into 20 behind the comma. Okay. Next, I want to give a dimension for the radius of the circle. Select dimension radial, and then left click at the circle. Next, we will give dimension radius for the small circle here. Select radial and left click at the circle. Okay, 6. Okay, right click to escape. You can move the number into the position. Right click to escape. Now we will give dimension for outside of the circle. Select dimension radial. Left click at the arch. Right click to escape and move the number into the position. Right click, press escape on the keyboard. Sorry. Next, select radial. Okay, left click at the arch. Okay, I think we have finished all of our jobs for today. Right click to escape. Okay. Yeah. Okay, I think that's all for today. Please subscribe to our channel to help us to improve our channel. And see you in the next video. Okay, thank you very much. Bye.